AFL forever.
Away from Tigerland, a fighting fury away from Tigerland. In any weather you will see us with a grin, risking head and skin. If we're behind, then never mind, we'll fight and fight and win. Away from Tigerland, we never weaken till the tide of tyrants gone. Like the tiger of old, we're strong and we're bold, for we're from Tigerland.
The mighty and Mopsy Fraser, the great centre line of premiership years 67 and 69 of Burke, Barrett and Clay, the greats like Roger Dean and Fred Swift from 67.
Both teams are giving everything as players force themselves to their limits in one of the most exciting grand finals for years. Ify is a picture of intense concentration as Ganane pulls down one of his better marks and has an easy kick from right in front. But it's not Ganane's day. His kick is off beam but a behind. For the fourth time, scores are level. The tension is taking its toll on the Tigers' coach. From 35 yards out, Lomelson's kick goes over the outstretched hands of the pack for a goal at the beginning of the time-on period. Richmond hit the lead, 108 points to 102. Clearing in to grab the ball, Bartlett turns and kicks his second goal after 28 minutes. It could be the match winner as the Tigers increase their lead to 11 points, 114 to 103. With victory in sight, Barrett smothers the ball, taking no chances of being beaten by an awkward pass. Geelong stay in the fight. Palmer passing to Costa as they stage a last-ditch attack. Scarlett just fails to mark in front of goal and loses the ball. Ryan grabs it to snap it behind, and the Cats still have a chance. Although the Andrew and the Geelong officials know it's a slim one. Grabbing the ball in a pack, Goggin has a long shot, but it's well marked right on the line by Swift. And Geelong's last chance is gone, as on Swift's clearing kick, the silence signals the end of a memorable match, won by Richmond, 16 goals, 18, 114 points, to 15 goals, 15, 105. It's a well-merited triumph for dedicated coach Tom Avey, who is acclaimed on all sides. So too Fred Swift, who realises his greatest ambition in his 10th season and after 157 games with the Tigers. Sir Kenneth Luke presents the VFL Cup to Fred Swift, captain of the conquering Tigers.
It's not that long since Richmond was one of the strongest teams in the league, and why not?